Amnesty International.
Do you believe that there is a risk that the fire control and for that reason that it's so important that security councils are on that commitment? It's so important that the African Union put their words into action.
Have you been in on the council to quickly do something about this, but is there anyone else that you want to help in this situation?
Well, the primary call is on the East African community. They've been leading the mediation in the region. They've actually reached a stalemate. We want President Mugabe, as the lead mediator, to step up now and get the different parties around the table to discuss a key resolution to the human rights crisis.
That was Sarah Jackson, Amnesty International's Executive Regional Director for East Africa, on the line from Nairobi, speaking to Kimberly Rivers. Zimbabwe's human rights are in the spotlight once again ahead of the 2018 elections. Civil society organizations yesterday issued a joint ultimatum to Zimbabwe government to apply the constitution and set up a peace and reconciliation commission to have it. According to Section 251 of the Constitution, a commission is supposed to be established with the mandate to deal with transnational justice and address past wrongs. However, Zimbabwe has been dragging its feet, with experts saying the ruling party is afraid of exposing its own supporters. Some of the claims are the same human rights abuses from independence in 1980. Summon Michelle,
report from Hello. Set up a National Peace and Reconciliation Commission in Nairobi, the political hardship is not in government effect. The call was made Tuesday by a coalition of Zimbabwean civil society groups in Harare after realizing the country was lacking the political will to move 3 years after the new constitution was adopted. According to Section 251 of the Constitution, Zimbabwe is by law supposed to set up a constitution that deals with past atrocities. Zimbabwe has a record of poor human rights from 1980 when the country gained independence from the white colonial rule. More than 20,000 Zimbabweans, mainly of the red country, were massacred in the southern part of the country in the 1980s. From the year 2000, some invasions began, claiming more than 30 lives, as well as inter-party